Lord is made, we'll rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to Morning Glow. Welcome to another time in the presence of the Lord. Trust in the Lord that this morning will be a blessing to you. Your life will never be the same. In the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we give glory, honor, praise, and adoration to your name. We thank you because you are a good God. You are an awesome God. You are a great God. We receive your blessing in this time, in the time in Morning Glow. We receive your favor. We receive your touch. Lord, bless your people beyond imagination. Make today, make this week an unusual week for them. Give somebody remarkable, remarkable, remarkable testimony. Let there be divine intervention in the story and the life of your people to the glory of your name, Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. We'd like to welcome everyone this morning from the four corners of the earth. We bless the Lord for you. We thank God for you. We trust the Lord that you will be blessed. You will be favored. The hand of the Lord will be stretched. God will prove himself as a mighty God in your life. In the name of Jesus, I'd like to welcome you from wherever you have joined this morning. May you be blessed. May you be favored. May the hand of the Lord touch you. May you be ministered unto in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, 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 amen. I'd like to celebrate everyone who's with us this morning on the Morning Glow. May you be blessed. May you be highly favored. May this week truly open up to you in all that God has for you, all that God wants to do in your life, in the name of Jesus. This morning, we are continuing. Tulse Hill, God bless you. Tulse Hill is southwest London. Tulse Hill. It's one of those places you confuse whether it's southeast or southwest. I think Tulse Hill is southwest since it's close to Brixton. All right. Malaysia, God bless you. Praise the Lord. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. We continue speaking into our lives this morning, particularly prophesying, possessing possessions. By way of inheritance, God's children have become bona fide owners of all good things in life. It is your birthright as a believer to receive what God has for you, to receive favor, to receive blessing, to receive grace, to move forward with your life as a person possessing possession, because Jesus said you are joined here with him, the right to own and enjoy everything that belongs to God your Father has been given to you. Because the Bible says, well, as many as received him, to them he gave power to be called the sons of God. So God wants you to know that you should possess possession, because it is your right as a child of God. It is your right to receive the blessings. So number one, the reason we are able to possess possession is because it is our right as believers. It is our right as bona fide citizens of the kingdom of God. The scriptures say, 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3, according as his divine power hath given us all things that pertain unto life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. His divine power hath given it. So when God's divine power gave it, which power can stop it? Only you can stop what God had given you. Only you. So don't let anything stop you from receiving what God has for you. Praise the Lord. So number one, you must know your right. Number two, you must have the knowledge of what is yours. Because you see, if you are in ignorance, you wouldn't know what belongs to you. You wouldn't know what your property is. You might even be paying for what is yours. Here, Hosea chapter 4 verse 6 says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Without adequate knowledge of what Christ has done for you, you can't help but be deprived. You may spend the rest of your life not enjoying those things which have been freely given to you. Freely given. Hallelujah. Obadiah 1:17 says, but upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. And the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. And from this scripture, it's obvious. Deliverance, holiness, blessings, everything belongs to you. God wants you to possess it. You cannot possess your possession until you are delivered from ignorance, until you are delivered from what holds you, until you are delivered from not knowing your right. One of the most told stories preachers have flogged and flogged that story is a story of a person who traveled in the days when the only way to go to the United States of America from somewhere like England was by ship. And this person got on a ship and they gave the person tickets, and the person got on the ship, and it was a 2-week journey. This person wouldn't go to the restaurant because they didn't have more money. They managed to get enough money to pay for whatever amount they were told to pay before they can board the ship to America. The person was migrating, and the person carried a few biscuits with them, a few crackers. And so in the whole journey, morning, noon, and night, kept eating the crackers and drinking water and eating the crackers and drinking water. And I think about the 12th or the 13th day out of 14 days journey, somebody sees the passenger and says, we've not been seeing you in the restaurant. Why are you not coming to the restaurant to have any meal? And the passenger said, look, it was a miracle to scrape the money to be on this ship. I didn't have the money to buy food. That's why I could not at all come to the restaurant. It was a miracle to just buy the ticket and be on the ship. And the person now showed this passenger that, look, when you paid for the ticket, it included the meal. The guy was getting to know the 13th or the 14th day that all these 14 days they've been in hunger and pain and just eating crackers. One good, succulent meal, nice meals prepared in the ship was meant for him. He didn't know, he was ignorant of his rights. He did not read the ticket well. He did not notice where it says all meals were included. He only knew when it was just about time to get off the boat. Too many believers are like that. They just hold on to one or two promises and they are screaming all over the place. They don't know what their rights is. They don't know what the word says. In fact, even if they know, they've not been able to claim it. This man is about to reach America on an empty stomach. He missed all the food, missed all the opportunity because he didn't read his rights. Knowledge is powerful. My people perish because of ignorance. When you know the truth sets you free. That's what the Bible says. If you don't know the truth, you are not free. To be free from the bondage of ignorance, you must actively seek for knowledge through reading, studying, meditating the word of God. Wherewith shall a young man cleanse his ways? By taking heed unto thy word. That word have I hid in my heart, that I may not sin against you. And I tell you, you may think it's just so hard, or some people are extra disciplined. I'm enjoying my new style. I wish I had done this a long time. This is one of the best years of my life. I first made everyone go through the Bible in 1 month. Now I'm finding that I go through the Old Testament once, New Testament 3 times a month. It is unbelievable for me. I mean, how come I'm discovering it when I've been 50 years in the Lord? I just find that the New Testament is much easier to go through, man. When you get to Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Ezekiel, you just get stuck in the old. But you see, I know that's just like information, but you see, after a while, you even know what the next statement will be. One time my son asked me, how do you know all those scriptures by heart? I said, because You just constantly read them, or constantly remember, or constantly hear them. Praise God. So information leads to transformation. Transformation comes because of rhema. What is rhema? You just find, I'm sure it has happened to you. One day, one scripture verse you've read and read and heard and heard. Boom! Just caught fire in your spirit. That is rhema. And that scripture, you ate it and drank it and drank it and stood on it and stood on it until you got the breakthrough you needed. That is rhema. The written word is logos, which is just like saying book. That's the original word for book. But the spoken word and the rhema is when it comes alive. So possess your possession through knowledge of the word, of what your right is. Lastly, this morning, possess your possession by not giving up. The problem with most of us is that we give up quickly. It doesn't matter what the situation or circumstance, you got to understand the enemy wants to resist you. He'll surely hit you. He'll try to stop you. He'll start to stop your breakthrough, but you must hold on to the word. And it must be like Joshua, who at 85, he said, give me these mountains. For as my strength was when I was young, so it is now. He said, my strength at 45 is just like now at 85. So if Joshua did not give up at such an age, you have no reason to give up. You must hold on to the word, believe God's word, and have no excuse. You must possess your possession. When the enemy comes, you resist him. Because the Bible didn't tell you that Satan wouldn't come. He will come. He will try to push you out of your blessing. But you must take your stand. Joshua became one of those who led a troop. He led a troop. I mean, we're talking at the time when they didn't have the kind of medicines we know today, the kind of opportunities we know today, the kind of mortality rate was very high in those days, although with the children of Israel, because of the fact that God gave them a hygiene system and God's supernatural grace was upon them, and then the covenant of healing was on their life, they lived long. Joshua lived long and strong at 85. Of course, you can see the benefit of believing God. He was one of the two who brought good report and stayed on the good report. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody, this morning, you are possessing your possession. You are taking your territory. Even the one the enemy stole, you are chasing the enemy out. You are possessing your possession in the name of Jesus. So don't give up. You too, like Joshua or Caleb, you can say, give me this mountain, for as my strength was. Hallelujah. So don't stop. Possess your possession. Take the territories. I want you to know that this morning something has to shift. God is going to glorify himself in your life. He's going to cause you to possess possession. And the things that have your name on it before you were born, they are coming into your hand. In the mighty name of Jesus. First of all, Lord, we give you glory. We give you praise. We thank you for another week. We bless you for the privilege of life, for the opportunity to see a new day. Thank you. Thank you. We will never cease to praise you, our God, our Father, our Savior. Thank you for keeping us all through the night. Thank you for waking us to a new day. Thank you for frustrating the hand of darkness. Thank you for counting us among the living. We praise you. We magnify you. We celebrate you. We make great your name. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It is not by power, nor by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. We return all the glory, all the praise, all the honor to God. We make great your name this morning. Kalere Shayera Baboka. We bless you because your word is true, your word is life, your word is power, your word is grace. Your word cannot fail. Everything you said will become reality. And so this morning, Father, we are ready to possess possession. We are ready to take what belongs to us. We thank you because the hand of the enemy is already frustrated for us, and the glory of the Lord will be revealed. All eyes shall see it, for the mouth of the Lord of hosts have spoken it. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We bless you this morning, O God. We bless your name. We bless your name. And as we prophesy into the life of your people this morning, let them possess their possession. Every favor you have earmarked, every glory you have earmarked, every blessing you have earmarked for them is coming into their life. For the word of God says, and Joshua divided unto the people their portion, their portion. Their portion, their portion. There is a portion for your people this morning, and they are coming into it in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. There is a portion for their health. There is a portion for their joy. There is a portion for their future. There is a portion for their progress. Lord, we thank you because they are coming into it. Nothing is stopping them. Nothing is holding them. Nothing is hindering them. To the glory of your name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Palestishka ebitonon brekeska yedoshina baretali branozungali edaba. We prophesy this morning, your people are possessing their possession. They are possessing their possession in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I speak into your life this morning that God's got a blessing with your name on it. You are coming into it. Nothing will stop you. You are coming into that favor. Nothing will hinder you. You are coming into what God wants to do. Nothing will stop you in the mighty name of Jesus. Exodus 15, 17. You will bring them in and plant them on the mountain of your possession, Lord. You have prepared the place for your dwelling. Lord, your hands have established the sanctuary. Oh, wow. I like to read this one again. It's lovely. You will bring them in and plant them on the mountain of your possession. Lord, you have prepared the place for your dwelling. Lord, your hands have established the sanctuary. This morning, I prophesy into your life that there is a place, a mountain of God's possession. Nalike tosunkayeti leboji. A place with your name on it. A place that God has favored. Your eye will see it. Your hand will handle it. Your mouth will testify. Nirindoro talishkai. Talibrosundai kedoza. Yedaba teleontoloshke de kaye pratosolon telimare taliskotolaraba. Everything that is yours. Every possession that God has prepared. Every favor that God prepared. Every blessing that God prepared, every glory that God prepared is coming into your hands. It's coming into your hands. It's coming into your hands. God is favoring you from today. And as I pray for you, wherever you are around the four corners of the earth, I want you to bring out a paper and write your dream possessions. Because as we agree with you during this period, the day is going to come when you will tick each one of them and say, as the Lord said, so it happened. Write down all the possessions that God is laying on your spirit. Write them down. 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 Lebo kaida I kodo seke. Rotali brono kaitali. Ronatali pakose pia tono talishandere kurubozia. Every dream. Every aspiration, every dream, every aspiration, every dream, every aspiration, every dream, every aspiration, every dream, every aspiration that God had laid on your spirit is becoming reality. It 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 is becoming reality. Irabo koshadare kosali yaraba. Every dream you write down, every vision you write down, spiritual vision, mental vision, emotional vision, financial vision, relational vision, I declare and decree this morning you possess your possession. Nikate kota tiretele zoyenama. I speak into your life today that God causes you to walk in supernatural favor, testimony in Jesus' name. I declare, I decree into your life today those dreams, those visions, those testimonies you've written, in the name of Jesus, they become your reality. Your reality. Your reality. Your reality. Your reality. Your reality. In Jesus' name. Nale baro toka belia shenda yeri keba. Baro kebe koso balita li remate li skabia talo siti yara baro ziyada. Now this morning we want to take authority over everyone who have stepped into what belongs to you by way of trying to steal your joy, steal your family, steal your possession, encroach into your right, encroach into what is yours. We send the Holy Ghost after them this morning. Exodus 23 verse 30, I will drive them out little by little ahead of you until you have become numerous and take possession of the land. I read it again. Exodus 23, 30. I will drive them out little by little ahead of you until you have become numerous and take possession of the land. Exodus 22 verse 8, if the thief is not found, the owner of the house will be brought to the sanctuary to learn whether or not he reached out his hand to his neighbor's possession. Everyone, every thief, everyone who has taken, who took what belongs to you, we send the Holy Ghost after them. We take back your possession. We take back your possession. We take back your possession. We take back your favor. We take back your testimony in the name of Jesus. Ah! And if they don't leave it, they'll pay double. They'll pay double. They'll pay double. Exodus 22 verse 8, if the thief is not found. Exodus 22:4, if what was stolen, whether ox, donkey, or sheep, is actually found alive in his possession, he must repay double. We send the Holy Ghost after everyone who have taken what belongs to you, the ones you knew, the ones you didn't know. We take back your possession. We take back your possession. We take back your joy, your money, your favor. I was shocked. The Lord laid on my heart last Friday to pray for people who somebody have tricked them. All these wonder banks that that tend to open up in Africa. Somebody run some wonder banks. And I felt led to pray for people to get back their money that have disappeared that way. And I made a call. I was shocked the number of people who came out. So it just resonates with this thing about possessing possession. Everyone whose money, whose peace, whose properties, whose land, whose joy, whose children have taken one way, receive it back double. Receive it back double. Exodus 22 verse 4, if what was stolen, whether ox, donkey, or sheep, is actually found alive in his possession, he must repay double. We take it back double, 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 rekeba, rotake, rekosa, peyate, shondali, kabero, zokai, zalibro, katikera, zarabarosi, kiaraba. In the name of Jesus, we take it back, we take it back, we take it back, we take it back, we take it back. We send the Holy Ghost after liars. We send the Holy Ghost after all those who are schemers. They scheme these people. They present to them. They lie to them. They create a system. They say, we're doubling your money. I don't know why people easily get sucked in. You know, I guess when those guys come, they come with a pussycat face, you know, just a meow, but when they are leaving, they live with the tiger face. They disappear. Nayado kake ko kaka paroso preye talelo shandale reba. Everyone on this altar whose monies, whose joy, whose property have been taken one way or the other, we take it back for you this morning. We repossess what belongs to you. We go after the enemy, we take it back, we take it back, we take it back, we take it back. In the name of Jesus, I take ozo ta ye kabo koso ta ya. He ko tare rosa le koso ta ye ka ke poko. In Jesus' name. Leviticus 20 verse 24. Leviticus 20 verse 24. But I've promised you that you will inherit the land that I'm about to give you as your permanent possession, a land flowing with milk and honey. I read this again, Leviticus 20, verse 24. But I've promised you that you will inherit the land that I'm about to give you as your permanent possession, a land flowing with milk and honey. Father, in the name of Jesus, everyone on the platform this morning, I speak into their life something you've already promised them, including the ones they didn't even know about. It's coming into their lives. It's coming into their lives. It's coming into their lives. Favor is coming into their life. Joy is coming into their life. Testimony coming into their life. Turnaround coming into their life. Open doors coming into their life. Every promise you have made is becoming reality. The Bible says the promises of God are yea and amen, which means yes and amen. God does not make a promise that he is not sure of. God is not the God of suggestions. He is king. Kings don't suggest. Kings don't propose. Kings carry out decrees. They do what they say they will do. From this morning, that which God has earmarked as yours is coming into your hand as a permanent possession, as a permanent possession in the name of Jesus, 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 as a permanent breakthrough, permanent turnaround, permanent testimony. Likuroti kalishkaya narabosa, ikale kusutala raboka, yineto sandele prosheta, itolose, indalerosa, iramatoseka, itoza barosheka, deronte roseria. Testimony follows you. I declare this morning that testimony follows you, favor follows you, glory follows you in the mighty, 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 mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Leviticus 25:13. Leviticus 25:13. In the year of this Jubilee, you shall return every man unto his possession. In the year of Jubilee. The year of Jubilee is the year of freedom. It came every 49 years, and then the 50th year is the year of Jubilee. We're going to start on this scripture also because it's kind of the year of Jubilee in the United Kingdom, because it's the year of Jubilee of the Queen reigning. So this day we declare that in this season of the Jubilee, somebody is returning to their possession. They are taking their territory. They are possessing their possession. They are taking their territory. They are possessing possession, taking territory, possessing possession, taking territories in the mighty name of Jesus. God is bringing you into favor. He's bringing you into blessings. In Jesus' name. Leviticus 25, verse 34. Leviticus 25, verse 34. But the field of the suburbs of their cities may not be sold, for it is their perpetual possession. When you have the word perpetual in law, it means no end. It's not a lease. It's not for a few years. It is in perpetuity. God says he's going to give you a blessing that is perpetual, something that stays in your family, that stays in your life, perpetual possession. Lord, we release this testimony into the life of your people. We receive perpetual possession. Every fight over what belongs to us, we take authority. We cast out the enemy. We shake out the enemy. We push out the enemy. We shake out the enemy. We push out the enemy. Male tosi, rekotayaba, hikosolabaro, italarabo sekia, isharabo sokaya, irabaro rosekaya raboro, shikentele rabo kosayara. In the name of Jesus, everything that has your name on it, you take on perpetually. Peace, perpetually. Joy, perpetually. Breakthrough in perpetuity. Favor in perpetuity. You need to say a big amen to this prayer, because when you have known lack and when you have known challenges, something at the back of your mind is afraid that you might go back to that lack and that pain. It's not of God. It's a voice of darkness. So this morning, as a servant of Jesus Christ, I prophesy into your life perpetual blessing, perpetual peace, perpetual breakthrough, perpetual testimony, perpetual following the Lord. You will not backslide. You will not go back. You will not turn your back on Christ. You will not turn your back on the gospel. You will not turn your back on the God who saved you, who delivered you, who washed you with his precious blood. You will not go back. You will not go back. You will remain in the faith. You will remain in the Lord. You will remain in the truth. You will remain in the blessing. I also prophesy on you today, you will not go back to lack. You will not go back to the little you used to be. You continue to increase, increase, favored, increase, 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 favored, increase, 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 favored. In the name of Jesus. From today, increase follows you. Favor follows you. Increase follows you. Favor follows you. Increase follows you. Increase follows you. Labarota liki barano sotayera. Ikalo zonke brose yari. Irabato sonte yarabalo. Isalere batalarada toro sekayere kabako zondalaraba. In Jesus' name. Leviticus 25 verse 46. Leviticus 25 verse 46. You shall take them as an inheritance for your children after you, to possess them for a possession. They shall be your bondmen forever. But over your brethren, the children of Israel, you shall not rule over one another with rigor. Here the Bible is talking about when people came to serve the children of Israel. He said, you take them for possession forever. They will serve you. They will serve your children. It's only that you will not do that to your fellow Israelite. In this place, it is talking about God lifting your hand, making you above a nation that is far above all of your life. This morning on this altar, I declare and decree that your family is rising. Your children are rising. Tali pago kali tali brana tala rondei ketabara. Everyone that have been in the place of suppression, oppression, repression, I break you free from suppression, oppression, repression. I break you free from every attempt of the enemy to trample upon you. You will receive the lifting. Receive the lifting. Promotion, lifting. Promotion, lifting. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak into your life today that God himself lifts your household, lifts your head, lifts your household, lifts your head, lifts your household, lifts your head, lifts your household, lifts your head. Tata kopa kariketa. God have made your hand strong. Your hand shall not be weak. God made your hand strong. Your hands will not be weak. In your family, your hands will not be weak. It says up to your children. It said even your children will possess them. This word will come to pass in your household. Likate do sotere kasali dalo zombre kate shotale rababo ikororo toliandela diramata da 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 radodoski hikiaraba toranamante rabarodose. In Jesus' name. Numbers 13 verse 30. Numbers 13 verse 30. Then Caleb quieted the people in the presence of Moses and said, we must go up and take possession of the land, because we can certainly conquer it. We must go up and take possession of the land, because we can certainly conquer it. Numbers 13 30. I lay hand on you this morning. Every land, every dream, every vision, every job, every business that you envisage in your spirit, every place the sole of your feet have trodden upon, every aspiration, every desire that is on your spirit, I prophesy this morning that you are taking territory, you are possessing possession. Taking territories, possessing possession. God will exceed the dreams you have written down. Remember, I told you to write them down. Remember, write them down. If you haven't written them down, the moment this meeting finishes, make sure you write them down. Hold them, keep it in your phone if possible. Keep it before your eyes. Halado shataya bekaza baro. God cannot give you what you don't desire. So you've got to write it down. Have your vision clearly. Make it, write the vision, make it plain. Then Caleb quieted the people in the presence of Moses and we must go and take possession of the land because we can certainly conquer it. You can conquer it. You can possess it. That finance is coming into your hand. That joy is coming into your house. That breakthrough is coming into your life. That testimony is coming into your life. That turnaround is coming into your life. Maleka ko ke keriala rotazo mareta makoje rebosa. This day I speak into somebody's life. I don't know who it is. There's been an ancient boundary drawn around your family. I see pillars as if they shall not exceed this place. But today, as a servant of Jesus Christ, I remove these ancient pillars, these ancient demonic pillars that have kept your family in one small tiny hold. And you people have not been able to spread to the left. You've not been able to spread to the right. And for anyone who tries to have a vision to go outside of the place, they bring him back. Today, I set you free. I loose you from that limited boundary, limited bondage, limited boundary, limited dreams that have been drawn around your household, around your extended family. Nobody who can be traced into your family had ever extended, had ever gone out, had ever prospered. But from today, you have come to this altar. We break you out of limitation. We break you out of the boundaries. We break you out of limitation. We break you out of the boundaries. We break you out of limitation. We break you out of the boundaries. We break you out of limitations. We break you out of the boundaries. Everything that is yours, you are coming into it and you are possessing possession. Dali dali baro bali kali kadi tarama taro doso tiarida reto pako sepa tose keto mampre telo skediaba. There is a favor with your name on it. Enter and possess every illegal occupant. I release fire, 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 fire upon their life. I release hot fire upon their life. Anyone who wants to take what belongs to you, they will not. I see somebody scratching their back as if they are being flogged. Yes. Let the angel of the Lord chase them. Let the power of the Lord chase them. Let the angel of the Lord fight them. Let the power of the Lord fight them. Anyone who wants to take your possession, who wants to steal what belongs to you as a child of God, let the angel of the Lord fight them. Let their peace be withdrawn. Nataku borusikia. God will expose anyone stealing what belongs to you. From this day, victory. From this day, favor. Then Caleb quieted the people in the presence of Moses and said, we must go up and take possession of the land because we can certainly conquer it. Why? How do we know we can certainly conquer? Because Jesus has already conquered. We are just manifesting his conquest. The Bible says we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. So it's already done. It's already done. So this morning we take in, we enter, we possess. We enter, we possess. We take the territory, sanali, take it o parina, lushkia levia, rota paso tali, rikabo siatia. From this day, testimony of Jesus follows our lives. Nekabakata, rota libikis, maliko tolevash, yili marondeliza liberante li kurumbaridia, I karadada rosia. Zikare Torabata, in Jesus' name. Numbers 14:24. But my servant Caleb, because he has had a different spirit and has followed me fully, I will bring into the land which he entered, and his descendants shall take possession of it. But my servant Caleb, because he has had a different spirit and has followed me fully, I will bring into the land which he entered, and his descendants shall take possession of it. Today, upon this word, I speak into your life that the things God is about to do in your life, the God of glory and virtue will show up for you. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Eka telebo, 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 and 4, the God who called you to glory and virtue. Then 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 says, the God who has given us everything that pertains to godliness. You are entering what is yours and you are taking. Litna untos yaka toka prake kosobari renodo talereba broskeyada mikodoroda hikararado hikayetala prakosotaya hikolozeri ramotolamazikia hikaraba zolisha malika hikorozi prande tombre tande rombra. I speak into the life of everyone on this altar today. You and the children that the Lord has given you shall be for signs and wonders. You and the children that God has given you will be for signs and wonder. You and the children God gave you will be for signs and wonder. The hand of the Lord will be mighty. The hand of the Lord will be awesome. The hand of the Lord will be great. Provision from places you never expect. Turn around from places you never expect. Blessings from places you never expected. God himself proving himself so mighty, 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 mighty in your life. The season of the turnaround has come. Enough is enough of being in the hold. I want to pray for somebody on this altar. This one, I saw you. It's like you are in a hold. You've just been waiting, 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 waiting. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Call waiting, hold on, hold on, call waiting, from today, things change. Receive the answers, receive the turnaround, receive the answers. This is the season of the answer, this is the season of the answer, this is the season of the answer, this is the season of the answer. No more hold on, no more hold on, no more hold on, this is the season of the answer. No more hold on, no more hold on, no more hold on, this is the season of the answer. Nalidi pakedo napre tosa preketaye ronate kepra nosotaya. This is the season of the answer. No more hold on. No more hold on. No more hold on. No more hold on. Things are beginning to change. Hiraba. So a vision of like angels carrying files and saying it's a ton. It's a ton. These are files. These are files. And somebody's ticking, 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 ticking. I know God is using anthropomorphic images to convey a supernatural action. As if the angels just come, say, I bring you. And then someone is taking, yes, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. No more hold on, 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 no more hold on. Enough is enough. This is the season of manifesting favor, manifesting testimony. Kaproto akekekota. No talika. No more hold on. In the name of Jesus. 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 Yerada hirota hikako kosa metali tali roto sekia heratotori yankade sontaliaba. No more hold on. No more hold on. No more hold on. No more hold on. Receive what belongs to you. In Jesus' name. We up the prayer for the next 2-3 minutes to warfare, to take possession. Numbers 21, verse 30, verse 24, verse 35, and verse 18, I think. Numbers 21, verse 24. Israel struck him with the sword and took possession of the land from the Ammon to the Jabbok, but only up to the Ammonite border because it was fortified. We are pulling down their fortification this morning. Numbers 21, verse 35. So they struck him, his sons, and his whole army until one was left, and they took until no one was left, and they took possession of his land. Elekaba, Hirotayara, Hiraba Solia, Hirabababa, Hirabababoro. Numbers 24, 18. And Edom shall be a possession. Seir also shall be a possession for his enemies. And Israel shall do valiantly. We go into the realm of the spirit. We say today, no more hold up, no more hold up. Every stranger that have possessed your possession, that is trying to steal what belongs to you, we chase them out. We bring fire to their tail like Samson put fire to the tail of those foxes. We put fire to their tail. We put fire to their tail. We chase them out. We take possession. We chase them out. We chase them out. We take possession. Every territory in the realm of the spirit, that is yours. You shall not be tired. You shall not be tired. You shall not be weary. You will take it. You shall not be tired. You shall not be tired. You shall not be weary. You shall take it. Every territory that is yours. Natika bika teko sapeta leto mareka ba rato pake tombre tesa. Every territory with your name on it, you will not be tired. You take it. 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 Every stranger. Every stranger, the Edomites, Mount Seir, we chase them out. These are unfriendly friends. Edom is an unfriendly friend. They are cousins. Edom is Esau. But they turned against Jacob because their fathers lost out. Mount Seir are also their cousins. But they turned against Israel. We chase them out. The Ammonites too. They are distant cousins. They are the sons of Lot. Naliri bikotaya, or shall we call them bastards, or children that were born out of, what's the name of that, when sexual copulation takes place between family, incest. They are children of incest. We bring the fire of God against everyone who is an unfriendly friend, who is stealing, possessing what belongs to you, lying to you. They shall be exposed. Every blessing that belongs to you is coming into your hand. You're taking possession. You're taking possession. You're taking territory. You're taking possession. You're taking territory. Hiraba kolosia, hirareba, rotaleba, kosoniyaraba, hiradaro. In Jesus' name. Two more scriptures this morning. And we close, because we're closing 7 on the dot this morning. Numbers 27:7. The daughter of Zelophehad, speak right. Thou shalt surely give them a possession of an inheritance among their father's brethren. Tekuzoliyadi. And thou shalt cause the inheritance of their father to pass on to them. Everyone on this platform today, they've discriminated against you on grounds of your gender, on grounds of your color, on grounds of your gender, on grounds of your color, on other grounds of prejudices, we send the Holy Ghost after them today. God fights your fight. God wins your battle. 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 We send the power of God after them this day. We take what belongs to you. Now, anyone who have messed with a child of God on this platform, they have put their hand in trouble. We said, I just saw a revelation of what happened in the Bible when hornets were sent after people and they chased them. Anyone who have tampered with your name, your life, your prosperity unjustly, they suffer the consequence. Everyone who have had prejudice against you because you are a woman, because of your color, because of your race, because of your nationality, heaven will shock them in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I close with Numbers 27, verse 11. If his father has no brothers, give his inheritance to the nearest relative of his clan and you take possession of it. This is to be a statutory ordinance for the Israelites as the Lord commanded Moses. For everyone who is here today who is an orphan or you have no relation and somebody is taking advantage of you, God goes ahead of you. He fights your battle. He wins on your behalf. Victory belongs to you. From this day, everyone on this platform, you are coming back with a remarkable testimony. Write the things that you believe God to do in your life. Your eye will see it. Your mouth will testify. Every other dream, aspiration, vision you have for this week It comes to pass. 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 Your eye will see it. Your mouth will testify. It comes to pass. It comes to pass. It comes to pass. Your eye will see it. Your mouth will testify. So shall it be. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Well, praise the Lord. I wanted to finish on the dot 7 this morning. And I believe you've been blessed and highly favored. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. Make his face shine on you. Give you peace. Make this week a remarkable week of achievement, a week of progress, a week of favor, a week of testimony, a week of glory, a week of the outstretching of his hand. Let me encourage you about the International Gathering of Champions. If you have not registered, you need to do so now. This year's IGOC is going to be so powerful. The theme, limitless, it's not just a theme. It is a prophetic word. God is taking you to a season beyond limits. And he has, in his providence, put together the people who will minister to you. You will have reasons to magnify the Lord, for his hand will be stretched, his power will be shown, his glory will be revealed, and his name will be awesome. Please challenge your friends to join us on Morning Glow. Go out of your way. Go out of your way to challenge them. And let them be part of the Morning Glow. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. All right. Pastor Matthew's itinerary. Next week, Wednesday, I'll be at KICC Maryland, Lagos, Power Night. Instead of Friday, we're having it on Wednesday. It's going to be an awesome, awesome, awesome time. Make sure you connect. You will be blessed beyond measure. In Jesus' name. And then on Friday next week, I am in Houston, Texas. It's going to be awesome, 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 awesome. The blessing of the Lord will be poured out. People will be healed, delivered, set free. I'm looking forward to Toye Ademola and Wumi Ademola. Awesome couple. It's one of those churches I enjoy whenever I travel to minister. I finish in Houston. And I go to, I think, Toronto, not America. I go to Toronto. Get to Toronto and minister on the 13th of July. Make sure you join us. Hey, I'm so looking forward to KRCC Toronto one night. It will be beautiful. You need more details, make sure you call the number on the screen, the handle. Then, from there, I journey to Redeemed Christian Church of God, Bowie, Maryland, Annapolis Road, Bowie, Maryland. It's going to be awesome. Great man of God there, Pastor Bayo Adeyokuno. Great friend. Good, very good person. So, the Lord bless you richly this day and favor you. Dio te vubenis. Dios te bendiga. Dios te bendice mucho, 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 mucho. Buana kubariki. Mwariba kukombrere. Iwo mzita. Rajesu. Mkulu mkulu. Agubu sesi. God bless you richly. Good morning. We see you tomorrow morning on Morning Glow. Blessings.
Join Pastor Matthew Ashimolo for a night of prophetic declaration at KICC Maryland. There will be healing, prophetic word, anointing for breakthrough, special ministration to individuals, ministering in songs, success, and osike. Date, Wednesday, 6th of July, time 6 to 8:30 p.m. Venue, KICC Prayer Dome, 13 Oki Lane, Mende, Maryland, Lagos. For inquiries, please call 0805-605-2300. Remember, it's on Wednesday, the 6th of July, time 6 to 8:30 p.m. Bring someone along.
Live in Toronto this July, Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo.
God has crossed his hands. Favor is coming to your house. God can favor you. God can bless you. God will give you influence. Lay hand on yourself, say influence.
Kingsway International Christian Center, KICC Toronto. presents One Day Revival with Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo. Date, Wednesday, 13th of July, 2022. Venue, 1087 Meyerside Drive, Mississauga, Ontario, Canada. Time is 6:30 p.m. prompt. It only takes one word from God to change your life. Visit www.kicccanada.ca or call +1 647 370 4920 for more details. One night of supernatural possibilities. IGOC 2022, August 24th through the 28th. There will be prophetic impartation and spirit-filled revival. Limitless with host pastor Matthew Ashimolowo, Depo Oliomi, T.D. Jakes, Dr. Bill Winston, Dr. Mensah Ottebil, Bishop Tudor Bismarck, Pastor Biodun Fatoyimbo, and Pastor Jerry Ize. Live and in person at KICC Prayer City, NE59QG, during the 12 daytime School of Ministry sessions and 8 free evening revival sessions. Register now for only £35 for the daytime School of Ministry, in-person or virtual attendance. IGOC 2022. Register at KICC.org.uk, for no word from God will ever fail. Whether in the new normal or at any other time, the Word of God has stood the test of time, and it will never change. Do you want to learn how you can use the Word in any situation? Then join hundreds of students from around the world at King's College of Excellence for the 2022-23 academic session. The King's College of Excellence offers you a virtual Bible school with a difference. Students from every walk of life are imparted with timeless teaching, the know-how, and godly application for any situation. From experienced lecturers, including KCE founder Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo, our cutting-edge curriculum, which leads to an advanced diploma, includes teachings on understanding and interpreting the Bible, kingdom principles, principles of faith, Christian ethics and life and ministry, personal development and spiritual life coaching, ministry and new technology, church administration and church finance, family life and ministry, and much more. Come enrich your Christian life at the King's College of Excellence Virtual Bible School. For details and to register for the virtual opening evening, visit kce.kicc.org.uk.